Hey hockey players, Coach Garner here from hockeytraining.com. In this video, I'm gonna run you through an aerobic conditioning workout that has a specific emphasis on hockey mobility. But you're gonna notice that there's no prescribed rest periods with this workout. This is because it's an aerobically based workout. It's a little bit lower intensity. So I just want you to deep breathe in between sets and go when you're ready. This whole workout is going to be done in four supersets. But the first superset, what we're going to do is we're going to rotate between lateral lunge and press with landmine press. I'm going to have you guys do both of them, 8 reps per side for 2 rounds total. For the lateral lunge and press, I want you to lunge laterally and press 2 dumbbells in the air in 1 consecutive movement. Notice how he's taking a neutral grip here and not a pronated grip. This is how we're gonna perform the exercise, and we're gonna do all 8 on one side before moving to the next. With the landmine press, I want you to set your barbell up either on a platform in the corner of the gym, or if you have one, in an actual landmine attachment. Notice we're not being overly explosive here. You guys gotta remember, this is an aerobic conditioning workout. The next superset in this series is a combination of seated banded abductions with one-arm dumbbell arc rows. For the banded abductions, you're gonna do 20 reps, and then for the one-arm dumbbell arc rows, you're gonna do 15 per side. But remember, keep deep breathing throughout this process and don't wait for a specific time slot. Go when you're ready. This should approximately be a 6 to 7 out of 10 effort. With the seated banded abduction, you wanna band your 2 legs together very close to the knee and move your knee outwards while keeping a good posture and your chest up. Notice here, we're not bringing the legs all the way back together, and you'll notice we're doing a modified version here as well. We're doubling over a band to make this work, but many gyms also have much shorter bands that are a lot easier to wrap around your knees. But either approach works. For the dumbbell one-arm arc row, you wanna keep your arm in a fixed position that's not extended, but slightly bent, and you allow your back and your lat and your upper back to bring the arm all the way beside your tailbone in one arcing motion. The third superset in this series is a combination between pistol squats and reactive plate drops. What you're gonna do is you're gonna do 8 reps per side and then move into the reactive plate drops and do 8 reps there as well. And we're gonna repeat this superset 2 times. For the pistol squat, it's totally fine to use hand support, but understand it for what it is. It's support and not there for you to bench press yourself back up. Here, I want you to go through a full range of motion, just like Kevin is. Keep the weight on your heels and drive straight up. For the reactive plate drop, you want to choose a light plate because this is not about weight. This is about your reaction time. Drop it at the top and catch it at the bottom. As you continue to get better at this, you can challenge yourself more and more by letting it get more and more airtime. The last and final superset for this workout is a combination between the iron cross and inchworm with extension. We're gonna do 2 times 8 per side on the iron cross, but then drop down and only do 2 times 6 for the inchworm with extension. For the iron cross, it's one of my favorite mobility exercises of all time, and you're gonna twist your lower body and upper body in opposite directions. So he'll notice how his neck is going one way and his lower body is going the other way to get the maximum mobility we can out of the spine. With the inchworm, you wanna slowly walk yourself out and then go into a full extension here. This is a combination of an excellent core exercise with a yoga movement to challenge our core, but to also get mobility out of the drill as well. I want you to contract your core throughout the entire movement. It should have 0 time off during these reps. Thanks for watching our hockey training video. If you liked that video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And for more information on hockey-specific workouts, click the link in the description below.